Hey everybody, welcome to my latest video. Today we're looking at another homemade ration. This one is based off of your average grocery store. So this store is right across the street from where I live. It is a medium to large grocery chain and carries pretty much the regular stuff. So we've got three meals, a breakfast, lunch, and a dinner style. We've got some snacks in between, and I'm going to go through with you and show you the ingredients. So first meal of the day, we're going to start with hot cereal, so you need some boiling water with that. You could probably do it with cold water, but I don't think it would be as pleasant. The next part, which does not go with this whatsoever, so you'd have to wait a while, is a pack of oysters and a couple packages of crackers. For a main meal of the day, I've got, this is Indian coconut vegetable. So there's stuff in here. It's considered hot and spicy, so we've got some protein to go with it. This is a dill flakes light tuna. I also have a spicy tuna, like with the cayenne pepper, or is it the chili pepper? Chili pepper, I believe. But I thought, this is already considered hot, why throw the chili pepper in? We'll take this in. If it's anything, it's going to mild it out. So that's your second meal of the day. Third meal of the day would be mashed potatoes, and then we've got these beefsteak nuggets. It's alternative to beef jerky, but it's chunks versus strips. So that's going to be the third meal of the day. And snacks throughout, we have a bag of peanuts, we have a Coffee Crisp candy bar, we have a generic granola bar, dips, the chocolate covered ones, a roll of everybody's favorite, random lifesavers. There's also some drinks in this mix. We've got an MRE surplus. This is from one of my other videos. It's a tea, whitener, coffee, and sugar together. So that's beverage to get you going. We've got three water beverages, Crystal Light, which I didn't really think about it when I bought them, but they're almost like zero calorie. So it's just basically a flavored water. A couple of teas. These are herbal tea. This is Moroccan style mint and honey and ginger. So being herbal teas and their fruit-based flavors, you don't really need any sugar or cream with those. It doesn't really go well. Another snack is going to be a cup of soup. And the other accessories are a pack of tissues. I got that when I went to the dollar store ration pickup because I bought a bag of like 8 or 10 of them for a couple of bucks. So I'll put one of those in there. We're going to go in with a spoon. That's a Canadian IMP. It's one of the current spoons for them, the spork. And our last couple of accessories, we're going to put in a Tabasco. So this is in case one of the dishes isn't spicy enough. This is almost pure heat versus too much flavor. And since I know the Italian rations are revered for their aperitif, I've got a few of these that I picked up. Going to the liquor store locally, they've had these, they call them on bottles. When you buy 26-ounce bottles, sometimes they'll have these little samples on for free. All you pay here in Canada, you pay 10 cents for the deposit of the bottle, but you get the product for free. So we're going to tuck that in. That is a Smirnoff Infusions cucumber and lime vodka, and it's 30% alcohol, so it's not quite as strong as the day-to-day 40% alcohol. Let's get that together, and I think I'm going to make two separate packets, one with the accessories and one with the mains, and get this a bit of bulk, so stick with me. We'll be right back with that. So now we're going to play the game we call Ration Tetris. So we've got the preform bag here from the Food Saver. I'm going to put in the thickest, heaviest item first, which is coconut chaff vegetables. Easiest to deal with is the butter and herb Idahoan potatoes. Right underneath, go in with the McSweeney's nuggets. And we're gonna do a little trick on this one here. Fold it over to get a little more space. And I've got the Gold Seal smoked mussels. Now they're in a box, which isn't gonna compress well, but I don't think that the actual product is labeled very well beyond that. Let's go in here and get this tin down lower. If I can get this up top, I think that'll go okay. That's the first bag. Alright, so we're going to tuck this in here as best we can. It takes a couple inches of material to be able to seal it properly to get that initial seal, and then you can back off and get that second seal. I'm just getting the bag into that channel, take it and lock it down. Try and seal, vacuum and seal. And she's going down. Okay, so I've got it sealed and vacuum packed, but I had to take out the Idahoan because there was just too much volume in here and it wasn't working right. So I'm going to put the Idahoans in with the accessory pack. We'll be right back. So we'll start with the Idahoan potatoes. Didn't fit in the first package. Put them face out. And I didn't spend a lot of time going into detail about nutritional info on this stuff because basically it's all commercial packaging. You could look it up online anywhere if you'd like to, because some people just have no interest in that, and I respect that. Hope these crackers hold up okay during the process of taking the air out of this bag. It might end up crumbly, but the intention was to use them with the oysters as either dippers or toppers. So if they do get cracked up, it's not that big of a deal. Try and keep it so we've got as much space up here as possible so we can enable that sealing process. I might even turn that label down with a bit of resistance. Tissues are not critical. This fork is not critical. It's handy, but it's not critical. Tea, coffee, doesn't take up a lot of space. Put that in there. Sugar whitener. Sugar-free drinks. I might try and get the tissues to line up at the top of the package. That might be beneficial because they'll compress really well. Doesn't have to be organized. Just get it in there. So I'm trying to think of what to do with these rations after I've made them. If you'd like to see me do reviews of the contents, make sure that's closed. Or I was considering having sort of a contest for people that have video channels that do reviews on rations and sending them out to somebody that can do a review on them. Because I know what's in them, but I'd like to see somebody else's opinion of what's useful and what's not useful, etc. So let me know in the comments below if you think that's a decent idea. And then if it is, then we'll try and figure something out to do that. Okay, I think we got her licked. Actually, having tissues up against the bottle might not be a bad idea. All right, we're going to take that to the vacuum sealer. All right, let's give this a go. Everything packed in there as well as we can for the accessory pack plus. By plus, I mean plus potatoes. Get that to close so the channel works well. And we'll try to vacuum seal. That's promising. And there's the first seal. And once that's done, we'll open that up, move it down 3/4 inch, lock it up, and do a second seal. And there we have it. Packed and well sealed, protected, and you're ready to drink. All right, so hopefully you watched the whole video so you know all the contents of what's going on here. This is what I would consider a 24-hour worth of ration. It's probably about 3 pounds. It's quite a bit of weight. There's a can or two in here. There is some heavy things like the ingredients of the cans as well. So yeah, let me know what you think in the comments, what you would add, what you would take out, and what you want to see in the next video. Thanks very much for watching. If you liked it, the content, please like, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.